marking its presence, its aim to deter the enemy.
You may think, who is there to deter? After all, the sea appears calm and there's no sign of trouble whatsoever, right? Well, wrong.
In November 2023, as the Israel-Hamas conflict escalated, missile, drone attacks and raids on commercial vessels at sea also began. These dots represent those instances the responsibility for which, in most cases, was claimed by Yemen-based Houthi rebels. Some attacks have taken place closer to the Indian coastline. While the US and the UK have resorted to airstrikes against the Houthis, India has wanted to step up its presence at sea. The BBC was given special access to this patrol mission in the North Arabian Sea.
We are with the Indian Coast Guard ship Sajag, also known as the Vigilant. This ship, a newly built one, has a crew of more than 100 personnel, and at sea it can endure for almost a month. It's ships like these that give the Indian Coast Guard the long legs it needs to go deeper into the Indian Ocean region.
But why are such patrols necessary and what do they achieve? Such missions have gained importance following the recent attacks in this region. This map indicates the amount of shipping traffic here. In volume terms, shipping is the medium through which 95% of India's trade flows.
अगर ये ड्रोन अटैक हमारे कोस्ट के पास आए हैं तो इसका मतलब है कि थ्रेट काफी बढ़ता जा रहा है और अगर ये ऐसे चलता रहा तो कीमतें बढ़ती जाएंगी आम जनता पर काफी भारी पड़ेगा और देशों के इकोनॉमीज पर भी भारी पड़ेगा
फिजिकली चेकिंग ईच वेसल एट सी इज इम्पॉसिबल That is where such shore-based centers fit in.
This is Indian Coast Guard.
Not only do they investigate vessels, they also help ships like the Sajag in deciding where to look. These measures, the government hopes, will help build a secure Indian Ocean region because
Indian Ocean region is that highway through which passes 75% of the global maritime trade. Contiguous to the Indian Ocean is the Gulf of Aden, the Red Sea and the Suez Canal, that nerve center of global economic activity which connects Asia to Europe. So intense is the pressure on the Suez Canal that every minute there are two ships that pass through that thin strip of water.
With the setting of the sun, newer challenges emerge.
Night is a particularly tough time for the ship. Because unlike nighttime in cities or villages, there are no reference points available. Reference points like streetlights, buildings, or roads, in fact. All there is out here is black, with an occasional twinkle out there on the horizon.
But the men on board Sajag can always look up for help. Helicopters enhance the area and the speed with which the ship can respond. The ship's response also entails turning its own lights off so that it can look outside clearly. We met the navigating officer who told us what his ship does at such times.
So the ship operates at IMBL, International Maritime Boundary Line between India and Pakistan. And every vessel which is transiting through that area, we investigate that. It is different from our general flow of traffic on the radar. Then it creates suspicion for us and we head towards that vessel. Then we give warning shots, we try to call him on VHF, if it is not responding, we go close nearby, we train our searchlight on it, if we find any suspicion, then we prepare our boarding party.
This is that party, and their work continues through night into day.
Thank you. dangerous operations that a ship can undertake is this. We are right now on a small boat, part of what is called as the boarding party. These are fully kitted up men. This boat is lowered from the main ship and then sent out to investigate whether it's a merchant vessel, a fishing vessel, or frankly anything that's amiss at sea.
Such operations also help execute intelligence-based drug seizures. And such instances have only gone up. Over 70% of the Coast Guard's total drug seizures have taken place just in the last 5 years.
At times, we have intelligence when the drugs are beyond our EZ, beyond our jurisdiction, and they are in some other country's jurisdiction. So in that case also, the Coast Guard is sharing the information. We have shared INT with the Sri Lankan Coast Guard and the Maldives Coast Guard, and as a result, they apprehended a cumulative haul of about 400 kgs drug was caught by both the Coast Guard.
But success on one front does not dilute the challenge on the other. More is needed, say those who understand the subject.
Drone ko itni dur aana, towards hamare pashchimi tat tak takriban aana, matlab ke unke paas jo equipment hai kafi badhiya hai. एडवांस वार्निंग की जरूरत है, रीडिप्लॉयमेंट शायद हो सकता है, फिजिकल प्रेजेंस जिसको कहते हैं वो बहुत जरूरी होती है. एसेट्स मेरे हिसाब से कम है.
द कोस्ट गार्ड मीनवाइल सेज इट इज एडिंग मोर टीथ.
नॉट दैट द ड्रोन अटैक हैज टेकन प्लेस एंड द कोस्ट गार्ड हैज कम इनटू एक्शन. आवर ऑपरेशनल फिलॉसफी हैज बीन 24/7 पेट्रोलिंग एंड बूट्स ऑन द ग्राउंड एंड विजिबिलिटी ऑल राउंड. The Coast Guard deploys nearly 55 to 60 ships every day out at sea. By end of 2026, our fleet strength will be more than 200 ships and our aviation wing will have more than 100 helicopters and fixed-wing aircrafts.
Today, every 10th man or woman working in merchant ships anywhere is an Indian.
India is a major supplier of seafarers, and therefore, I would believe that there's almost no ship that passes through this area that does not have an Indian on board. These men and women, a lot of ships have women, so, and their families undergo stress while they are at home.
Meanwhile, on board the Sajag.
So we've been on this ship for about 2 days and a night, and it is time for us to go. But we thought before we go, we'll show you a glimpse of where we've stayed. This is a twin sharing room. As you can see, there's a study table, a covered sofa. These are the bunk beds. Also a small glimpse at the toilet here. This is a room that Kenz and I shared. So for as long as we were here, this place was home.
Name and contact of local agent.
For the men on the ship though, home is a distant thought. These gentle waves mask the turbulence that's unfolding.